Hi everyone, you're welcome back once again to my channel. My name is Mary and I'm glad to have you back into my space again. If you're new into my channel, thank you for stopping by today and remember to subscribe, like, share and subscribe. We upload video here every week and you don't want to miss anything. For the returning subscribers, I want to say thumbs up to you. You guys are awesome. Thank you, stay by, and let's get started. So today's tutorial is going to be on how to make ruffle throw pillow. So I have here with me the fabrics which I'm going to be using for the project. I have the long strip, which is 5 inches wide, and the length depends on the size of the pillow. The pillow I'm using is 10 inches by 10, so I'm going to multiply the strip by 4, which is 40. So I'm going to cut the length of 40 inches. I'm going to be using this for the filling of the pillow. The red fabric here, I'm going to sew all the 4 sides and I'm going to leave about 3 inches opening for me to stuff in the pillow stuff. I don't know what the name is, don't ask me. So I'm going to be filling that in once I'm done. I'm done sewing the pillow, so I'm going to be pulling out the edges to make sure I have a nice sharp edge. And I'm going to be filling in with this stuff. If you guys know the name, just kindly leave me a comment in the comment box. I don't know what that thing is called. I can't remember. Yeah. So I'm going to be sewing 1/2 inch. As you can see, just have a closer look at what I'm doing. So just pull it in and sew it from the place you stopped. I've done that and the thing is looking very neat and nice. It's just a nice comfy pillow. What I'm going to do next is to put gathers on the strip. The strip width is 5 inches by 40 inches wide. So I'm going to be folding it into 2 to put gathers. I have done gather stitch before. If you haven't watched my video, I'm going to leave a link up here for you to watch. It's easy. If you have the ruffle footer, you can use it to put your gathers. But if you don't have the footer, you might want to use your hands and be careful while pulling. So I'm done pulling and this fabric for the pillow is 10 by 10. What I mean is 10 by 10 inches and I have 3 of these pieces. So look at it closely, the way I'm placing the fabric. This is how I'm going to do it and at the end of the day, you have an opening there. The strip is ready, so I'm pinning it on the pillow fabric. So you lay the fabric flat as it is and pin it all over around the 4 corners. But if you're comfortable sewing without pinning, then you go ahead. Otherwise, you have to pin to know whether what you're doing is right. Otherwise, you have to take it out and sew it again. So at this point I'm done pinning and every corner is lying flat, so with the way it is, I'm not going to sew over the ruffle. The ruffle is ready and I'm going to be placing the fabric over the ruffle and I'll fold in about 5 inches in and I'm going to be placing the small leftover fabric over it. And I'm going to make sure it's flat, it's laying flat. And I'm going to pin the four corners. This is just to secure it to make sure it doesn't shift while I'm sewing. I'm going to be taking it to the machine to sew, and when I'm done, I'll bring it and show it to you how it looks like. I'm done sewing, so I'm going to make the big reveal as it is. So this is where we stuffed it in, and I'm putting my hands there to bring it out. Big reveal, voila, this is lovely. Everything looks good, and I'm checking to make sure I didn't hold the ruffle, and I like the way the ruffle comes out. It looks so neat and full, so I'm going to slot in my small pillow in it. I had so much fun making this pillow, and the pillow is looking very nice. I hope you're going to give it a try. It takes only less than 1 hour to produce this pillow. The pillow is so gorgeous. I like the ruffles. The ruffle is well laid and full. This is our gorgeous pillow. This is magnific. Ooh, I love the red. I love the contrast. This is lovely. I hope you're going to give it a trial, and if this pillow tutorial has been useful, please leave me a comment, like, subscribe, and share with your friends and loved ones. And if you are a new subscriber into my channel, I said thank you. Please subscribe, like it, and share. And remember to leave me a comment should you want me to make you anything, or you know, describe anything, explain anything. I'm available. Thank you once again for staying by, and keep watching my channel. Keep loving yourself. God bless you.